The time has come, children.
Again.
Yeah, because I shot this once, but it was without you.
I'm part of the channel too.
Greetings, salutations, and all around. How the hell are you? And welcome to the very, 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 very long-awaited survey results vlog. So, at the end of the year, I was very sad. And in not a good place, but I am much better now. Thank you all so much for love and support. It has not gone unnoticed. And neither has the survey results. I talked about this in the previous vlog and of the update nature. No, I'm gonna flip this over just because I can. Just because I can.
I haven't done that yet.
She freaks out because I can do that with her laptop.
I've never done that before. I know I could, but I didn't.
It's fine. It's a tablet now. But let us go through the questions one at a time. And I have video supporting this recorded previously. But first question. How did you originally discover the channel? Use other if via a specific creator, channel, or video. This was my first mistake.
Yeah.
Because an overwhelming amount of you learned of my existence via Tony Goldmark, aka some jerk with a camera. So I decided to fix this with a new chart.
I have it, honey.
Chart will be appearing in its full form on screen right now. Only two of you said monster vlog, so that's fun. In person said five, so I'm guessing that's like maybe in a few others. But to kind of combine all the Tony Goldmark answers, that was about 42, but there was still edging out that, I wanna say,
roughly the same
is the top 25 list and the Universal Retrospective. There were two of you that said, well, two of you who had one response for Doggins and one for Illnej, so thank you for acknowledging them.
Yay!
But absolutely none of you, none of you came to the channel for RBG Gaming. let's see, just to round this out. 9 for the insert title here review series from 2008-2011. Really old school. Channel Awesome, formerly That Guy with the Glasses Forums. I don't have the exact number on there, but it was a...
around 10 or so.
About the same margin as ITH.
Mm-hmm.
XNO/ReviewTopia. That was only 3 of you, so thank you, Nick. And 4 from GeekVision.tv. Excellent.
How question are you notified about video uploads on the channel?
Now, this was a more streamlined question because, as you can see, I didn't have to make another chart for it. And this one is an overwhelming amount of people getting it from the YouTube subscription box. I believe the reason I asked this question is because it's been a problem a lot lately with a few creators having videos actually get out to their subscribers via the subscription box, which is why they have to beg and plead everybody to like ring the notification bell. But even that comes with its own caveat of problems and like needing to say that you actually want to be notified of uploads. Like that was first place, and second place was the YouTube notification bell, email or phone notification. So hooray. One of you said the YouTube front page. That's interesting. And they're not subscribed, but they're a patron. They're a patron, but they don't have a YouTube account, so they just check every week. So that's another interesting caveat of non-subscribers.
Mm-hmm.
Now we move on to the more interestingly asked questions.
Yes.
Which of these popular channels do you also watch? Check all that apply.
This would also be a good chance to explain to the lovely people what all these channels have to connect back to you.
Yes. So Defunctland, the king of ParkTube.
Current.
Right now, the current king of ParkTube, at a resounding 89 responses saying that you also watch that channel. And, you know, of course, this relates back to the theme park related content on the channel. Second is, with 64 responses, Lindsay Ellis and her lovely, lovely video essays. And I love that this one is right below Lindsay Ellis in terms of... deservedly
it's
so.
Not right below. It's a bit a ways away.
In third place below Lindsay Ellis in terms of responses. But like Channel Awesome, aka Nostalgia Critic.
So for the old school kind of what I call the Madagascar style of
and link up, thank you, up dear. There for explanation.
Of content review.
All right, in fourth place, Andre Black Nerd. Andre Black Nerd Comedy.
He does more like editorial about pop culture and nerdy mm-hmm. topics.
All right, right below that is Markiplier.
Your voice twin.
Yeah. Either way, Let's Plays, RBG Gaming, that sort of deal. And then in last place, Swoozy, who granted is more of a sort of lifestyle vlogger and, you know, more of a just vlogger in terms of relationship.
Mostly stuff. Story time.
Story time stuff about like, so I was with a girl who didn't make out, but I was jealous about this other guy having this, like stuff like that. However, that's not how I found the channel. I found the channel through his videos about when he was cast member at Disney World. And I think those are some of his most popular videos. And videos regarding ex-employment at a theme park.
But you're not an
ex-employee. I am not an ex-employee at a theme park, but...
You know, maybe someday.
I have a break glass in case of non-employment plan.
Hopefully that non-employment won't be sudden.
No, hopefully it won't be.
It's a retirement plan.
It is. It's more of a retirement plan.
It's a story time retirement plan. Which of these lesser known channels are you familiar with? Check all that apply.
And in first place.
I feel like this is cheating. 94 responses, 85% is my channel. Thank you.
Yep. 94 responses because, I mean...
It's not like I'm not here all the time.
I mean, in second place is... Who is this? I think this one's Garrett.
I think so too. I'm pretty sure.
Which, you know, again, people would know that because, you know, we're besties. Does good music stuff. Also talks about the Pokemons and, you know, just also talks about like a wide variety of topics. Very much so in the same vein of Andre Blacknerd. Uploads not as often, but you know. Who's next after that? Voyages of the Royal King. Again, another obvious one because he's here.
We share
an apartment with him.
If not, subscribe. Although there is a big dip between Garrett and Zach.
Garrett, yeah.
Zach, because it's a newer channel. So if you had subscribed to RL King before, check again. You might need to subscribe again to his new channel.
Mm-hmm. Right after that is Remain Seated with Chris Nevergall. Who you have said in the past is...
He is the Carl Sagan to my Miss Frizzle.
Wonderful, wonderful, like, well-researched videos. Mm-hmm. Well put together, too. Like, I would say he, like, in the writing portions of his videos is where he's, like, the strongest. Mm. Above, you know, even me. And I would say, like, a lot... I did try to take a lot of inspiration from... like the smarter people for the latest universal retrospective just to, you know, because I want to be smart too.
You are smart.
After that, surprisingly, 19 people, 17%, are aware of The Obscure from and Memory Lane. And again, another type of channel that I would say is
if
a variety channel.
You've heard of Defunctland, but haven't heard of The Obscure. Boy, oh boy.
Granted, I will say on the in terms of presentation,
it's more performative.
It is more performative,
but it's a great performance.
Great performance, and I would say like it might turn a few people off just with the voice alone.
Oh my God! I gotta get some chicken.
And then surprisingly, after that, MC Prophet, who used to be my actual visual twin, before he grew a beard.
He grew his beard out.
But now he's on the same coast as us.
Really? Nice.
Oregon. Because of course it's Oregon. Everybody's moving to Oregon.
That's where all the game devs
are. So I'm not surprised. Yeah, just more analytical videos about video games, which, you know, I talk about video games on this channel too. And then last but not least, it was because of the Castle Chocula video that she started following me on Twitter. And that is The Homicidal Homemaker.
Who makes horror-themed cooking videos.
A horror-themed cooking show.
She made pull apart monkey bread that looked like entrails.
Pretzel bites that look like severed fingers.
Mm-hmm.
She
made the ear pudding from Dead Alive.
And also her most recent one.
She did a jelly roll based on the carpet from The Shining.
That's her most recent one. I put her on there for specifically more aesthetic dreams. Aesthetics to monster vlogs.
Aesthetic
and like,
goals.
Yeah, aesthetic goals. So someday we'll be that cool with monster vlogs. And we come to the question. What content, video topics do you typically watch on the channel? Almost
99.1%, 109 responses.
Out of 110 survey takers, reviews of theme parks.
Or reviews, parenthesis, theme parks. So yeah. Theme park
reviews. Right after that, you are here for 86 of you are here for the channel updates and general vlogs, which... Okay.
That just means they're here for you.
Thank you. You guys are awesome. You're too awesome to me.
Your personality is on brand.
But then right after that is the reviews of movies and video games, and...
That's a 70%.
Then for Monster Vlogs, right after that is RBG Gaming, and that's...
Now that was a skip between... movies and monster vlogs, because that went from 70% to 40%.
Yeah.
Which, that's fine. Monster vlogs is still kind of in a building stage.
Right after that, in terms of the non-other responses, are song parodies. So 36 of you are here for that.
Those are fairly new, so...
They are fairly new, and will be expanded upon someday. And then we have one response each for a bunch of these. So one of them is for the funny stories, the bad reputation, and the cat video that I did, which I consider that more of a vlog, but that was like a failed series idea. And the Q&A
hanging video. Out vlogs, like when you would stream all the time.
Older stuff is really interesting as well. Cool. Reaction videos, just one of you.
Someone's here from the Godzilla trailer.
And then you sleeping. Thanks, Zach.
That was Zach. What content... parentheses video topics do you enjoy watching on the channel the most? 86%, so not the entire
This is the stuff that you are here for mainly.
Yes, the stuff that keeps
it's not like
back.
The stuff that you watch regularly. This is the stuff that has you coming back, and this is also another reason why the branding of the channel has changed,
because it is majority theme parks.
That's what
theme
has me the viewers.
Is Pac-Man, and then everything else is inside his mouth.
Literally everything inside of his mouth. Wow. All right. So, what is in second place here?
That green.
Is that Monster
Vlogs? Monster Vlogs.
Monster Vlogs is in second place. Like, outside of the theme park stuff, people really like horror stuff. I mean, they kind of go hand in hand, especially when Halloween Horror Nights rolls around.
Yeah.
Which I'm not sure.
We put out some good horror stuff, so I'm proud of this. We should just do more monster vlogs and theme park stuff.
And I want to say in third place
is movies and video games.
Is reviews of movies and video games.
And then fourth place is RBG Gaming.
Yeah, RBG Gaming, and then channel update and general vlogs. After that, it kind of devolves into one response. Of saying whatever you make whatever makes you happy and creatively fulfilled. Thank you for that. I enjoy all the content you make, reviews in general, and let's plays. So
we're gonna throw that in the other category.
Yeah. So yay. Now this next question, granted, was a bit of a sneaky one, because of the next question that would be asked after it, and that is.
Would you be interested in RPG Prod's merchandise being sold?
About three quarters of you said
yes.
Yes, roughly 75%, but it's about 73%.
26% was like no, and I'm like.
Because the next question is, are you aware that RPG Prod's merch is already being sold?
On my Redbubble shop.
And more of you were like, no. Have you gotten any hints? After I did advertise it the last couple of times?
I got more views. I haven't seen as many hits, though.
Okay. Well, outside of Redbubble, I think I might do open up a Teespring. In fact, okay. I already have opened up a Teespring. I've just yet to design anything. Because YouTube has this thing, like if you are in the partner program, you can just directly advertise the merchandise from your Teespring page mm-hmm. on your YouTube page, like below the video.
So if you like any of my RPG products merchandise designs from Redbubble that we would like brought over to Teespring, because maybe you like their quality better or whatever, I got that Redbubble back in college, I'm not very discerning. Then let us know in the comments.
Now, in terms of Patreon, we do have a bit of an update to this, but let's get this out of the way. If you currently support us via Patreon or are thinking of supporting in the future, whose content, who would you want to support more?
A majority of you are not patrons, so.
That's fine.
That's fine.
That's perfectly, perfectly fine.
And then the second place after that was both.
Both.
So 23%, 26 responses said you would support both of us.
Because the way the Patreon was set up was that it was supporting both of us because we didn't really need two separate Patreon accounts.
Same production bubble.
Everything
goes to the same bank account. We have a joint bank account. It does not matter.
But in third place, y'all are just, 12 of you are here for just me.
Mm-hmm.
And then one, this was like right before I closed responses, but only one out of all 110 are here for just you. You have one hardcore fan cub. They don't care about me.
Thank you.
Just one fan cub.
I have, because of the new Patreon guidelines that were set in place recently, I did set up a Patreon of my own. Once again, monetarily, this makes absolutely no difference to us. All goes to the same place, goes to the same costs. The only thing is that his branding is very different from mine, so it would probably look weird if I linked to a Patreon that it would all be his face.
So I
don't have anything on that Patreon right now. It's a bunch of Lauren Ipsum. But I do have one in case, you know, we feel the need to branch out our brand.
Do you have anything set up for people to start?
Nope.
Have you officially launched it yet?
I've launched it.
Support her on Patreon.
You do not need to contribute to two separate Patreons.
The one fan cub that's here for just her.
You have no reason to contribute to two separate Patreons.
Absolutely none.
So it really does not matter.
This was when we were trying to decide.
If
it's
easier to remember his Patreon, go ahead and do it. If you were there first, go ahead and do it. There is no difference.
Because the reason we asked this question in the first place is because we got some advice from Dom to say, like, create separate Patreon accounts because that means you might, you know, actually come out ahead. But yeah, we were thinking about doing a little Patreon divorce, and now it's kind of accidentally happened anyway, but
it's there. It's not something I intend to use a lot of. Because if you're already here, same bank account.
It doesn't matter.
It's really just for going forward. If one of us hits viral.
And now, in the same vein of Patreon, would switching to a per video format affect your support? And this one almost split the votes. Because the majority of you said no. Like, you're here for the long run. You're here for, like, whatever. Plus, Patreon also has that option of only supporting one post as opposed to all posts. Yeah. So that your bank account doesn't accidentally dry out and you're no longer able to support yourself, let alone anyone else.
And the way I see it, as long as one of us in that Patreon put out a video each month, then it didn't
it wouldn't matter.
Much difference. But if you're going to put out more than between 1 and 5 videos a month,
which last year between April and November, it was 5 a week.
But then 42% said maybe.
42, yeah.
And then 10% said a definite yes.
Yeah, a definite yes. Like they were just like jump ship entirely. And
no.
So that was a monthly thing.
But would it be like a per scripted video, like the way Dave does it, or would it be per video period, the way like Tony does it?
I mean, the way Tony does it, he releases about one video a month anyway.
And he puts effort even into the unscripted videos. Like
exactly, like the one movie later stuff.
There's a lot that goes into a one movie.
Especially if it's like a movie like Endgame or even Infinity War, which we weren't a part of, but...
We support.
We will be a part of the Aladdin video. I don't know if that's spoiling anything, but yay, we will be returning. Which, by the way, we do need to put an RDA request for that. But the last question was an open-ended short answer question, and even now I still haven't had time to go through all of them.
So let's go through them now.
I don't want to go through all of them in this video, but they basically, the majority of them break down to... Don't stress yourself out. Just like do what makes you happy. Take care of yourself. And I would say for the last 5-ish months since I put out that video, things have been pretty good. Like there have been a couple missteps here, but none that are just as world shattering as I was at that point. That's not to say that I won't be at that point again. It may have been just like all the stress that I was going under or undergoing because of like keeping up with that 5 videos a week schedule, which I'm surprised I did majority, but the other side of thing was like more consistent schedule and all that. But the main takeaway was like doing what makes me happy and just focusing on my well-being. And yeah. And I think I've been living up to that. And because of the survey, like a lot of changes have been happening around the channel, like I said in the last video. And at this point, we'll see where that all takes us. The response to ThemeSnark as a brand has been pretty well received. Universal Video has been pretty well received. I've had one guy come up to me twice now at work saying, like he's watched the same video over and over again. I honestly think he does like construction updates too. Cause I saw him with like a pretty, like a steady cam rig the second time. We'll see what happens over the next however long this keeps up. And that being said, I don't think I'm going to be doing another survey at the end of this year. Maybe I will, I don't know.
I might.
You will. Cause this has definitely helped me shape like the future of things. Like I would say without this survey, I wouldn't have had the idea to rebrand. And yeah, it's just all 110 of you and even all 2,500 of you and counting. And even on her end, like 10,000 or 1,000, like, no, not 10,000. Like 100, not even one, where am I going with it?
1,000.
Like 1,090 people and counting. You know, we do thank you for the support and all that good stuff. And yeah, so subscribe if this is your first time. I don't know why this would be your first video, but...
Lordy.
It'd be a heavy-handed video, that's for sure. But yeah, keep on rocking, everybody. And we'll see you later.
Bye.
Bonus nachos, kids. Thank you.